everybody, I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails, and guess what? I'm loving leopard print at the minute, clearly. But some people have asked me how to do leopard print in acrylic. So that's what we're going to do for you today. Right, so we're going to do a stiletto nail. So I'm going to take this tab. Some people don't use this tab, and when I see them, I think, why? What are you doing? You need to put it on the back. It makes it double the thickness, which makes it super strong. That's what you need. I'm going to close that end, just like that. Just like that.
She should even get in touch with you. You're not exactly where you said you wanted to be.
I think you pulled in too tight on the top, Camry.
I can pull out.
We have got like a whole selection of videos that go through thoroughly about how to put a form on for different shapes. So we have got a video just about this. But for this video, I want to concentrate on showing you how to create this leopard print design in acrylic. If you've not seen this video yet, oh, you need to see that. It's a bit special. I'm gonna dehydrate. So I've already prepped the nail. I mean that I've taken it off and mutton mulla mulla bit. What I mean is I've taken it off the shine. So I've buffed over and took the shine off. Adam, stop blocking the light with your hands.
It wasn't that bad, was it?
We're bickering today. Friendly bickering, but we are bickering today.
It's been 5 days of together.
5 days, we're still beginning to slightly annoy each other a little bit. On purpose.
Oops. At least I cook for you. What have you done for me lately?
I've done nothing for you lately. Acid primer. Just on that natural nail. I'm going to do a thin base of clear. So I make contact with the nail. So slightly going onto the nail, and then I can pull the product down into shape. Pulling it and pressing it will make you create that thin layer. Gonna make sure this, see you've got that hard line there. Just wanna soften that with a wet bead. Just to soften that edge. But what it will do is it'll create a little lip. So when we put these colours on now, because we're going to use some coloured acrylic, it would catch under that lip. This is metallic gold.
Just, you know what could happen.
Was looking for it earlier. Couldn't find it. And then we have Cosmopolitan. They're all these on their own are just gorgeous colours. Belgian Fountain. And we've got some pure black acrylic as well. So I'm going to go on with the metallic gold. So I'm brushing that on nice and thin. So because I'm doing it thin, that's why it was important to get that rid of that lip, because you would have seen that lip. I'm going all the way down to number 3. Then we're going to use a bit of Cosmopolitan to add some shadow. So we're going to texture the coloured background because we want it to look more realistic. And then with the Belgian Fountain, you're going to create these little patches. They don't need to be solid. Now, if you don't want the glitter, then you're a really silly person, because who wouldn't want glitter? But if you don't want the glitter, if you want something more flat, you could just use, for like this part, you could use the pure brown acrylic powder. And it's important to keep the direction of these patches in the same direction. So you see that I'm sweeping my brush this way all the time. Then with the black acrylic, you're going to need a 3D brush for this because you want to pick up, beads that are a lot smaller. You're going to do those markings that a leopard has around the edge. Do not make a full circle, don't make it neat. You want it to be inconsistent. I love artwork that isn't basically perfect all the time. I like it to be quite random. Make sure you flatten them out as well. Then we're going to add some tiny, tiny little markings, tiny black markings. So once you've laid all that down, we're going to encapsulate now, and this is going to give us a lot of strength to this nail, and obviously it's going to encase the design, protect the design. I'm going to start here, quite a big bead, tip the finger down, get the cuticle nice and neat, and I can start to chase the product down the nail. And pulling and pressing. I'm going to rehydrate that bit. So I need an extra bead just to encapsulate right to the tip. And we're going to let that dry a little bit, then I'm going to pinch it. So I'm going to do my normal filing routine. I'm going to buff the nail now to smooth it out. Wipe over with acetone. And I'm going to top coat with the Urban Graffiti top coat. And that's going to bring out all the colours and that sparkle. Put me that in the lamp. So it's nice that you can see all those different tones. So you can see a Cosmopolitan running through as well. Finish off with a little bit of cuticle oil. Very nice. I like it. Haven't you got some pants, Latte?
Yeah.
Yeah. Hayley told
and a bra.
Me, Hayley told me you've got some pants. I didn't know about the bra. Like, I'm too sexy for my pants.
You used to have. Remember them Robbie Williams ones?
Oh, yeah.
The tiger on the front. Yeah. I used to have some of them.
So there you are, guys. Hope you've enjoyed that video of how to create leopard print with acrylic. Everything I've used today will be listed below. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And make sure you subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell if you want to have notifications to tell you that we've uploaded a video. You will never miss a video. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.
The rock to the bang bang boogie, say up jump the boogie to the rhythm of the boogity beat. A skiddly bee pop, we rock the Scooby-Doo. I said, hey, Naio Nails, we love you.